Next up, we have a presentation regarding a future tiny home subdivision proposal for the corner of Franklin and School Draw Avenues. We invite Etienne Croteau to present.
Merci beaucoup. Thank you very much. Thank you to welcome me, a member of the council, Mr. Mayor, staff of CDR. Thank you to everyone to come here by interest about this project. What I would like to ask to you, if it's possible, for the question period. My English is not really good. Then I have a friend, Carol. She will help me. But if it's a technical thing, I ask to you, if it's possible, to ask to Linda Bussey to give me some precision, if it's possible. Thank you very much. Then let me introduce myself. My name is Etienne Croteau. I work in town since 4 years now. I live here. What I would like is to establish myself permanently. But I will not have the means to become a homeowner considering the value of the property in your life. My story is simple, and I think it has many people here. What I want is contribute to the community of Yellowknife. I work for a French community organization, and I'm really proud of that. My difficulty to find a place to live with a reasonable price was pretty hard. And if the case, I have to sacrifice my privacy and share units with one, two, or three people. After 3 years to doing this, I'm convinced that there must be a solution to unit self-sufficiency and personal economic sustenance. One question came to mind, then how I come a homeowner with a budget, my budget situation, as many. The tiny house was my answer. Then it's the best solution for me to have a better quality of life, have the possibility to generate personal savings, have the ability to get a return on my investment because I own my own house and I can sell probably and buy another bigger one if it's possible. But I prefer tiny home. Have benefits and advantage for both the city and the residents. The tiny house neighborhood, and sorry for the mistake, I put a T. Okay, sorry. And the date is in French. Yeah. The tiny house neighborhood project could be answer resident retention by giving them an innovative and economic option for first time home ownership, and therefore answer long term residency for all Yellowknife citizens, include all people. But, yeah. Access to this project will also give the participant a better chance to realize personal objectives, such as founding a family in a favorable economic situation, or investing spare time in volunteer activities within the community, for example. Let me introduce you about the tiny house movement. What is this? The movement became more after the popular was more popular after the real estate crisis in the United States. What are tiny houses? The tiny house movement, tiny living. Simply put, it is a social movement where people are downsizing the space that they live in. The typical North American home is around 2,600 square feet, while the typical small or tiny house is around 100 to 400 square feet. The tiny houses come in all spaces, sizes, and form, but they focus on smaller space and simplify living. People are joining the movement for many reasons, but most popular reasons are because of environmental concern, financial concern, and seeking more time and freedom. So what is the alternative? What might be to live smaller? While we don't think tiny houses are the solution, there are lessons to be learned and applied to escape the cycle of debt where almost 70% of the population are trapped in right now. In a small space, you can just possess the essential, not more than that. You can't buy more because you don't have the storage for. It's a good thing, you spend less money. The carbon print foot is reduced a lot, and you have the control on all your waste. It's a solution for a best future and another option to change our way to protect our environment. Let me introduce you about some zoning plan other city proposed to create some zoning for that. One of them, it's here. It's on the Brett Laff Drive, done by Les Rutcher, with a smaller, tiny log house behind the Midnight Sun Gallery. Probably many of you know this place. It's a project was previously approved by the City Council, and that seems to work well. We could base the Tiny House Neighborhood project on this one, and tailor it to the tiny house movement they promote. Another one, it's Lemon Cove Village in California. The modification in zoning to accommodate an RV park zonage in town with a city-owned land. Additional regulation could be applied to adapt this zoning for the tiny house on wheel to make sure it's only for this kind of trailer. Long-term lease could be signed with the city hall. Similar project, yeah, exactly, can be found in California, as this one. And the last one I propose is a project we call that P3D development. It's in Quebec. It's a new project with the city of Lantier. They create an eco-residential area. They create a place where everyone share access and responsibilities to services, much like a cooperative. On this land, all the residents could be owner of this land, but could also rent this land from the city hall and share the fees. It's what I propose. Common space for children, facilities, and community garden just inside. The picture is pretty small, but you have this area in the center, then you can share. Sharing a solar energy renewable resource combined with regular power. And yeah, exactly. Then what now? It is my greatest hope that the City Council of Yellowknife will consider the Tiny House Neighborhood Project. I know you are considering already new option of habitation in Yellowknife. What I wish is if you can include tiny house on wheels in this kind of project. To achieve this project, I propose that the initial step will be to enter into a pilot project where the city could grant me a 1-year lease on the city-owned land that you see most fit for this project to happen. Once the pilot project is started, I will kindly ask for the City Council to ask to city staff to examine the different options and make recommendations on best option possible to make the Tiny House Neighborhood Project a reality. I would like to thank the council member and the mayor for their time, and thank you to your Yellowknife citizens to come here today. It's prove your interest about that. And we have to change, you have to propose something that Yellowknife can probably make that happen. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Merci, Etienne. I just want to know the difference between the one in California, okay, and the one in Lancy, that's my hometown. That's where the project is.
Okay, so, then you know.
And, but they're not on wheels, right?
Those not. They are on permanent foundation.
Okay.
Yeah.
And why would you want yours on wheels compared to those projects?
Because the other project, it's really linked to a permanent foundation linked with the service of town. Or as what I expect, it's maybe to have on wheel and have a service as old town. Then we can have the tank and carry our water and some house, I think, use a compostable toilet. It's really because also it's to be able to move with the house sometime. And I know in town, I think the city council is pretty open about that, but we never talk about on wheel. It's my principal proposition. It's really to maybe create the RV park. It would be easier to make this project happen. Then the difference, it's pretty much the foundation.
And when you say RV park, you're talking about tiny homes on wheels, or you're talking about
tiny home on wheel. Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for
your questions, Councilor Bell. Mr. Chair, thank you very much, Etienne, for the presentation. How much space do you need in terms of lot size? Like if you have one tiny home requires how many square feet of yard space, or what is ideal?
Probably the best for probably could be 15 by 30. My tiny house, it's respect the quote of the road, then it's 8.5 feet by 22. Feet. Then just for have some room around, by lot, could be a good size.
Thank you. Councilor Wong.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Etienne, in the future, I know this is not the time, but in the future, would you be willing to have city staff and councillors and the public tour your tiny home and look at your tiny home?
Yeah. When would be ready? It's pretty soon. Yes, for sure. I will do, I began some presentation in Erie River. I'm come back at the end of the month also for doing another one. And I will invite any people interested to know more how we can build that and how, what is the process with the insurance company. And believe me, I passed through each step. Then it would be a pleasure. Yeah.
Thank you. I just wanted to also confirm your flexibility here. You said that clearly your preference is to make this work on wheels, on a trailer. But given that, you are open to living in different parts of town.
Yes.
You're open to different arrangements, both for yourself and for a future tiny home neighborhood. Open to all sorts of different models, some of which you've given examples here today.
Yeah, of course. And we talk about, the presentation was about the land just behind Arnica Hotel. This land, I know the zoning, it's not proper for that. But the city council and the city staff know more than me where could be a project like that. And maybe an addition of, on that is my house. I try to adapt that. If the city council asks to me to put that on a permanent foundation, I work hard to make that happen, then will be possible because I respect mostly all the code. It's tiny, but it's almost 350 square feet. And I'm still really open to have your advice.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Councilor Sun.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Adrian, for your presentation.
Thank you.
Even though you said that your English was a great idea, it was great. Your French is much better than, no, your English is much better than my French. I have a couple questions regarding, so have you, has you or your group looked at what locations you prefer in the city?
But the best thing is where, I can compare it with the Ferdinand camping ground. The location is really great. It's nature. It's great. Otherwise, my main purpose is many people don't have a car. Then I talk more about close of the downtown or till we can use a bike. A bike too. And it's not too much a big deal. but the preference is to have a greater area we can adapt. And yeah, for some families have a place where we can create a camping ground in the center. It's a dream now, but I don't know what will be happening.
Thank you. And my next question is, so let's say the council agrees to approve a particular location, whether it's downtown or outside the outskirts, how would the group or how would you see the residents being selected to live there? Would it be a draw or would it be a group condo? Like a
what I expect, it's we can compare that as a cooperative, but it's really linked with the city hub, because what I would like and what I propose and other idea can come really, and I still open, I propose that to you, but it's a pilot project. It's really to if we can have some additional regulation, like to approve a candidature to be in on the lot, have to respect the tiny home concept movement, then could not possible to have an RV park on this land. The RV park, it's really for any park. Then we have some different additions. Quand on adapte une loi, on lui fait un amendement.
Amendment.
Then I think after that, a committee of selection could be a good idea. Just to make sure we follow the rules and also the rules of the CDR.
And I guess my last question is, are you visioning, or is your group visioning, that the land that's set aside for this particular project is all excavated and ready for use, or would your group be providing that contribution to? Mm-hmm.
What it's easy, probably with the RV park, it's because we don't need too much to excavate and do some stuff like that. It's easier because we just have to park and put on block, and like that we have facilities. Then if we have to drop some waste or compostable toilet stuff, we have a place has RV camping ground. Like that we are more autonomous. Maybe the only thing we could have is electricity. The power, like have a 10, don't know the name for that, but electricity for each unit, or an emitter for each unit. Maybe it's the thing. Otherwise, the propane are autonomous with the big one, 400 liters, I think. I try to think that more simpler as possible to make that happen as soon as possible. After that, all the proportion, it's possible if the CDL think it's better if we put that on permanent foundation, or we don't know how, I don't know really how it could work for now. Yeah.
Thank you very much.
My pleasure. Thank you for the question.
Thank you. Thank you for your presentation. Question. So just so clear, so Lemon Cove Village in California, that was all temporary leases? They were renting the space?
Yeah, it can be a long-term lease.
Okay. And was that... Is that leased through the city, or is it public property?
It's
private property, sorry.
It's a private. It's good.
It's private, and then people rent from them? Okay. And then in Quebec, it could be rent or buy?
In Quebec, it's just buy.
Oh, just buy. Right. So
you can buy just the land and build your own house on it.
Okay.
Or you can buy for $100,000 with a tiny home on it.
Okay.
And now it's ready for you.
So, have you approached any current landowners about seeing if you could lease or buy their lot?
Who?
Like any...
For now, I think with the bylaw, I'm not really... I'm really on a gray zone. Then it's pretty hard for me to... If I follow the regulation, I don't have any place. I can put that on the land of a residence, because can't the the bylaw, when you change the bylaw about a secondary suite on land, we can just rent those space. We can't buy. Then I can't be the owner of my house on a land of someone. The only thing I found is to put that on a parking lot. As any RV, in town you can see like a 1,000 RV like that. For now, it's my only solution. I think if you have a proposal, I'm ready.
But with your pilot project, you were looking to just do a 1 year lease?
For now, I could have two. Maybe it's ambitious, but for now, I hope, because the process, I don't know how many time can take for the process. Then 1 year, maybe it's enough, or we'll see.
But would your goal be to own that land, or would you always want it to be a lease?
For now, I can't. I don't have the budget for own a land. And for this reason, I would like to work with the CBR to with one of your land, then like that I can rent for a smaller price, probably.
And,
and own my own house on the one of your land.
Okay. Yes, you said lots about 15 by 30.
Okay.
Thank you
very much.
Thank you. Councilor Crowe.
Thank you. Thanks for your presentation today. I think it's almost full circle. Yellowknife was a lot of the first people the Yellowknife lived in what would be considered tiny homes today. So you haven't looked at really any areas in town, but you would prefer the RV style model, if I'm understanding correctly.
You can repeat the question again? So.
You would prefer to have the RV style, but you don't really have any, like, is there 15 people who want to do this? Like, do you have any idea how much land you require at this time to do this?
In the pilot project, I talked about 10, just as a pilot project. And it's also because the flexibility of an RV zone, it's about when you build on wheel, to follow the building code, it's not required. But what I didn't do that. I try to respect all the code for make sure if the CDL, maybe you could ask, okay, you have to put that on block. But your question is good. It's just because the expenses to put that on block and be linked with other services and stuff, it's increased the expense. Mm-hmm. Then I just have to see what is the best option. And also, it's a good option to be on a permanent foundation, just about the insurance. The insurance will really cut dramatically.
Yeah, the insurance and then also the servicing. I mean, it is, you know, it's a pilot project for 10 homes. The cost to put in 10 meters for a pilot project could be quite expensive. I mean, I'd like to skip right over top, skip the pilot project and go right to a tiny home community. I think areas in town like Cordel Bay, which would be well suited to that. You know, but I mean, if I'm understanding, you don't really care if, you know, if the city comes back and says, hey, you know, tiny homes, right on, we're going to do this, if you would happily take your house and take the wheels off your trailer and make it permanent.
I could do that, no problem.
But your toilet is a composting toilet?
Yeah, I heard some house in town have compostable toilet too. Mm-hmm. I think it's something okay. You could confirm. But
did the administration confirm that now?
We were promoting that when we discontinued in fact, I think we purchased it, right? At the time, for the dozen or so homes that were still on.
Sure, that's correct. We have about a dozen homes, I think 10 to 12 homes that were still receiving undergrad service. So we actually gave them I don't know if you call it a bursary, just so they could purchase the composting toilets. It was a set amount, and gave them the option of composting versus propane toilets, and they'd have to make up the difference.
So that's in place. I do believe we changed our zoning recently, so some smaller houses are allowed. You know, I think we're close to being able to do this. Now it's just a question of where.
Exactly.
You know, so it's, and in order for it to work, you know, and be affordable, that's always a tough thing in Yellowknife because we're on you know, the Canadian Shield and servicing is not easy and that sort of thing. So I think the amount of people, you know, I don't think in the 3 years we've been here I've ever seen this many people in the gallery. It's a great thing. So obviously this is something that Yellowknifers need. Yellowknife needs people to want to be here and stay here. Mm-hmm. I think it's a great presentation and it's certainly something that we should be looking more closely at.
Thank you very much. And just, yeah, so.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And 160 people wanted to be there today. And I know we are all a busy schedule, but I'm pretty happy for the number we have now. And it's a good thing.
That's good.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Etienne, I just wanted to point out that one possible strategy here going forward might be to work with city administration to develop not only the one strategy for a pilot project, but a parallel strategy at the same time for downtown locations. In my day job as a realtor, I've had numerous people approach me. Some of them want to build or buy one tiny home. Some want to build multiple and sell them to others. I've had two contacts from the south who are interested in selling, but they sell them in the south and wanted to find franchisees up here. There's a lot of interest in this. And I mean, council, when we took a look at the secondary suite legislation, I think a lot of what we were doing that for, a lot of the reasons we supported that are the same reasons that we're now talking about tiny homes. And there are areas of town, obviously the downtown being the main one, where we talk continually about trying to increase density. So while having one secondary suite of maybe 800 square feet on the back of a large lot, backing onto a laneway, that brings one family onto that laneway, but tiny homes could bring three families or couples onto the laneway. And that's obviously very attractive for, I mean, that was a part of the conversation and it's what we're looking for. So, I mean, I happen to know of about eight lots in the downtown, some of them two or even three side by side, where you could get six of these, maybe even nine, and you could have the private developer put in place a septic tank, put in place the power outcome. So, as well as talking to the city about getting a piece of city land, I think working with the city to figure out how the what the insurance implications are, the zoning implications, is there a site-specific zoning that we could use on a particular spot downtown? Could we create a laneway community with houses, you know, on lots where the houses are positioned closer to the road and there's ample space at the back to kind of do 6 or 9 of these in a row? So I would recommend that you pursue both of those strategies, and not just for the sake of your own project, for the sake of all those who are interested in doing this, because I think there would be really good uptake. We haven't seen a lot of uptake on the secondary suites, if any, right? If you put that stuff in place and we haven't seen any proposals. So we need to find ways to achieve those objectives more effectively and more quickly. And if secondary suites aren't the way to do it, if the problem is ownership, you know, if that is one of the main obstacles or one of the main incentives for folks like yourself, then I think this council and a lot of the private landowners in the downtown would really be interested in having these conversations.
I'm pretty happy.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Further questions for the presenter? Seeing none, thank you very much, Etienne.
Thank you very much for all of you. Really, thank you.
Thank you. We'll open up for discussion.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. You know, just to bring everyone up to speed, in 2014 we did amend our zoning bylaw to allow provisions for these secondary suites and also tiny homes. What we did is, you know, the zoning bylaw said you needed to have a minimum square footage to build a residential structure, and we just took those away and said you can go as small as you can go. But clearly there is much more work that needs to be done. I mean, what we haven't done is address the land problem. So we have made it easier to build tiny homes, and there are folks like ATM that have built tiny homes, in this case on a trailer, but they still don't have anywhere to put them. Or rather, they don't have anywhere to put them that's affordable. So, you know, how do we take the next step? And how do we finally make tiny homes or a tiny neighborhood a reality in Yellowknife? You know, keeping in mind that this is about housing diversity, density, affordability,
So if we can, as Councillor Conga suggested, skip the pilot project stage and roll out a tiny home neighbourhood, I don't know when your demand is in the next 3 months, if we're ready to do that, and I say we go ahead with that. If we hear from staff that we need some more time, we need a year to get through some of these challenges, then I do believe we should embrace ATN's innovation. And we should work with him to find somewhere for him to park his tiny home, execute a one-year lease as a pilot project, you know, so we can begin learning with him through his case the challenges that we will encounter for this subdivision. I think we can learn by just doing here and getting started. And Etienne presents an opportunity for us to work through this, both to address his immediate need and his pint-sized housing plan for the future. And yeah, I think there will be some technical challenges. You know, we've talked about building codes. What about on wheels or on a foundation? We've talked about zoning. So I think there is definitely some work to do, and I don't think we're going to resolve that here today. But certainly as someone that has spoken in favor of tiny homes with regard to Grace Lake South and the Capital Area Development Scheme, I'm going to continue to support our staff to find a place and an arrangement for ATN, and also work to present longer-term options for a tiny home neighborhood. So while I don't have the answer in front of me right now, I am confident to say to our staff that they do have my support to go and make this happen. Thank you.
Thank you. Councilor Vanthuyne.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Thank you, Etienne, for your presentation today. Long overdue in my view, quite frankly. The city has been talking about possibility of tiny homes community for quite some time now, and it's nice to see, and it's refreshing to see somebody that's coming in and wants to really talk about the possibilities of a development. As you've heard a few people say with amongst council already, I would fully agree that there's an opportunity somewhere to be found with regard to actually developing the tiny home neighborhood. But I also see tiny homes fitting in so many other areas within our city. We have potentially 90 plus lots coming up available on Grace Lake South in the future. There's no reason why we can't give consideration to some kind of zoning component that would allow for tiny homes to be even allowed up there. The territorial government, industry, tourism, investment, in particular the parks division, has talked extensively about the need to expand for RV parking in this city. What that looks like exactly, I'm not too sure. It would like to be out on the highway somewhere. But again, that's an opportunity to be collaborative in having, call it permanent or semi-permanent, tiny homes on wheels that are based there all year round, and then a certain amount of lots maybe that are available for visiting RVs that come and then overflow from the likes of Fred Henney Park and what have you, could end up going into that tiny home community on a, call it a month-by-month rental type basis. In the downtown, that's a lot of where we have our multiculturalism is in our downtown. We have a lot of diverse cultures that live in the downtown, and many of them have rather large families, and those families like to stay together for long periods of time. A lot of time the mother or grandmother has been with the family for a long time, and there's generations staying in a household. We've talked in the past about having nanny suites or in-law suites, as they're known, built detached from the house. So the house, once it runs out of space, we allow for, in this case, a tiny home to be built in the backyard or wherever it may be situated that will allow the family to stay together longer, because now someone can get out of the household and get into the tiny home. So I see this concept working very well in many different areas throughout the city, and of course, not only is it going to provide suitable and adequate housing, it provides another option at a certain particular price point that fits certain income levels, but it'll also be a generator of business, small business.
You know, it brings economic development to their community. So I fully see myself in support, and we look forward to you working with the administration going forward and hopefully bringing this to a reality.
Thank you.
Thank you. Councilor Bussey.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. I just want a clarification following Councilor Alty's question to Etienne before. The piece of land that Mr. Rocher has where he has those tiny homes on, that was his own developed, so we proved that he developed the land in that fashion, right?
Mr. Thomas.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Mr. Hummel.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. That is correct, and that was done as a planned unit development, so that's a little bit of a unique planning tool we used to accommodate that based upon the setbacks and the size of the home. So we did modify, as you will recall, there is no size restriction on the units. Where we have a bit of a challenge in terms of going forward is making an amendment to actually, I think, have a specific zone for tiny homes in the zoning bylaw, and that would probably also warrant a development scheme for people in the neighborhood as well.
So, but those tiny homes are leased now, right? So my question is, so if I was a private developer, I could have own a piece of land in town and get it zoning to be able to house tiny homes, correct?
That's correct.
Thank you.
Further discussion? Councilor Alty.
Thank you. I think we are a lot farther along than we were at the beginning of our council through secondary suites and by removing the minimum floor space of a house. And just even looking, school draw, we've got property for sale, lot 9. It's a medium density residential zoning. So if a group of 6 to 12 individuals wanted to create a tiny home condo with this lot, would that be possible under the zoning? It appears to be.
Mr. Fox.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Mr. Helmer.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. The sizing of units typically is related to the type of zoning. So the single family zone, the R1 zone, is where you typically find this. The problem with the R1 zone is the lot sizes are very big. So it would not be economical to put a tiny one, for example, in a lake lot, even though theoretically it could be done. So like I'm suggesting, I think we'd want to look at a specific lot, for example, the school draw lot, and then see if we can designate an appropriate zoning category for it. And match that with the development scheme as well, that would look at the engineering issues and servicing issues and all those other issues. And, there's probably warrant to look at a half a dozen sites throughout town to figure out what is the optimum site for these kinds of things. Because there's certainly going to be pros and cons, I think, with a number of these sites moving forward.
Okay, thank you. Yeah, because when I think of the RV spot model, really could just be condo where you all own your land and you're paying a fee to share that space. So I think there's a lot of potential either through the current land that the city has up for sale or properties, you know, a couple lots downtown are owned by one individual. So whether a bunch of tiny home individuals want to approach that developer and create a condo type system that way. So it's a great presentation and something I think as council we could work on a little motion to get working with the MIN on. Thank you.
Thank you. Further discussion? Mr. Conley.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. A few questions for administration. I would assume then that anybody, Kam Lake is zoned for residential now, so if somebody had a lot in Kam Lake and three or four tiny home owners with their trailers wanted or needed a place to park, that that would be allowed in that zone currently? Is that correct or incorrect?
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Mr. Humble.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Council may recall one of the administration's initial recommendation was to have pure residential out in Kam Lake. There was a secondary component to that, which that there must be a business component to each lot and site. So there is a minimum requirement that would need to be met. And there's probably a bit of work to do if you're going to get multiple tiny homes on a lot. Again, that's not to say that it can't be done and accommodated in Kam Lake with some zoning modifications.
Okay. Cordel Bay, and how far along are we in that one? Because I think that would actually be a good location for this type of thing.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Mr. Humble.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Council will recall that's been to council several times with the design layouts. We are proceeding down that path. We went to RFP, I believe that RFP was awarded last week to an engineering consultant company to commence the detailed construction design. That would set the pricing for the approximately 25 lots that are going on.
Just to confirm that the administration will need a motion of council to start moving forward on this.
Mr. Bell.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. That is correct.
I guess I'll give no sub motion then. We'll work on wording later.
Any further discussion? So I think perhaps just as a first logical step, if Etienne wanted to come in and meet with our planning department, I'm sure Mr. Humble and his staff would be more than happy to get the ball rolling on that conversation. And I think given the general support during the discussion this afternoon, that we can craft a bit of a motion to direct administration to more fully explore the tiny home concept and what we might need to do to revise some of our bylaws in order to facilitate that, as well as identify potential pieces of property around the city.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. I just wanted to add, Etienne, you've been busting down the language barrier here today. Also been busting down the barriers to tiny homes and Yellowknife. So I see you as an innovator, and everyone that's shown up today is an innovator, and I just wanted to thank you for everyone for coming out.
And also that Councilor Sutherland assistance.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Councilor Conch has asked my questions.
Thank you. Anything further?